win just was like the best win of my career. That's what it felt like. And then I think a lot of people thought we weren't going to get to the semis, but after we lost the game against Brazil, we felt like we should have won the whole tournament. So it still felt like a disappointment to us.
What can you say about it's that Brazil advanced to the Olympics?
They played well against us, and then they turned up and even played better against Latvia in the final. So they deserve it. But I think if not them, then it should have been us.
Dwight, Coach Tim said that you could have played your full potential when you played your natural position. What do you say about that?
I agree. It's hard if you have to do a lot of things on the court, but if you have, like he said, Scotty would have helped relieve some of the things because he can do a lot of things, and then I guess it lets me do more in certain areas than if I have to kind of balance everything. So he's right. If Scotty was there, I definitely could have done more.
How does it feel to be part of the historic Philippine team that won over a European team in about 60 years?
It's a big thing. Something to look back on, for sure. But I hope there was more to it. I hope it could have been to the Olympics, because it felt like it was just right there. I mean, for me, I was actually like, I thought people were going to be happier, but pretty much everybody was like, you know, it's still a tournament, it's just one win. So everyone was happy that we won, but it wasn't as happy as I thought. So I think everyone was still thinking that we could win the tournament now.
Dwight, perhaps do you have any message to all the fans that that supported you and Gilas Pilipinas, especially despite the fact that it was early in the morning here in the Philippines, and yet they are warmly supporting you there in Latvia?
Yeah, I would just say thank you, because I mean, even we're playing far away, there's a lot of Filipinos in the stadium, and then of course everybody here is staying up watching late at night, so it just gives you extra motivation when we play.
How bright is the future of Gilas Pilipinas after that stint at the OQT?
Super bright. We still have a bunch of years until the World Cup, and we really only practice for like 4 days before we left. So 4 days of practice, we still made it to the semis. I would just say I'm very determined. I always had a lot of setbacks, but I never let it stop me. So I just kept going forward, kept building, and then I got to where I am now. I would say maybe just more accessibility, easier for people to watch. A lot of people are streaming on the apps nowadays. They're not watching on TV, so I guess that was one way, if there's finding a way to stream it on apps rather than trying to play it on TV, because I don't know too many people that watch TV nowadays. To be honest, Chris Newsom was more of the point guard and I was more on the off guard. I only played it a couple minutes a game. Chris really did the whole thing. But yeah, Coach Tab is always trying to prepare me for that. I still feel more comfortable playing as more like a shooting guard. But yeah.
But how did your FIBA experience, how will it help you in your new season with Levanga?
I just feel like I keep getting better. So especially when you play well in like the World Cup and then now the Olympics or Olympic qualifying, it just gives me more confidence that like I can show up in these big games. So when I play in the B League, I'll be ready for sure. I don't have any injuries, but my last injury, I was out for like a month before the games. And so wasn't able to get into my like very best shape before the games, but I have more time now, so I can get into better shape for the B League season. I just be myself. On TikTok, I don't even post TikToks, so it's usually other people posting TikToks, and then I don't know. I just live my life, and whatever. If they're posting about me, if they're not posting about me, it doesn't affect me really. So it's me and hers. just a couple of days with us, and I already love them.
Back to you know, file their PBA drafts. Can you talk about that? That behavior. What does it say about the opportunities for players in overseas? Is there any significant change? That's why they're coming back, or we can't really look at that way.
I think just it's hard playing overseas. It's not your home country. You don't feel as comfortable, and then you're by yourself for like almost the whole year. And so when you do it over the years, you kind of feel like you're missing out on a lot of things. You're missing your family. So sure, that's probably what those guys felt, and they just wanted to come home and play in the Philippines. And they're all going to do great here because it's their home country, and they played here for so long.
Do you see yourself playing the PBA in the future?
I think so, eventually. I don't know when, but hopefully.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.